Hey guys, Caleb's Cards here, coming at you with another Antique Mall episode video. This is Adventures in Antique Mall Finds, where I go through live with you, getting the reaction of buying or going through some of the boxes or binders or whatever it might be of the sports cards or items I picked up. I have not gone through these boxes. They've been sitting behind my table to sort for a few weeks now. You're probably like, how could you not go through them? I don't know either. I guess I just, you've been doing YouTube long enough that you just like, I need to save those for a video. So we'll see if this box is worth it or not. It was marked for $25 and there was 30% off of that price. So that puts it about a little under 20 bucks. It was like, $18. I think it's $18 total for this. So we'll see if this was worth it or not. You guys definitely let me know down in the comment section below. Also, you know, if you see some favorite cards or maybe something you might like, let me know too. I might just be able to send it to you. So this box was opened already when I bought it, so somebody could have rummaged through it. I'm not entirely sure. Usually they tape them. So it looks like the head tape because it's removed. But as far as I know, the seller seems to find stuff in like storage auctions or something. So whether they sorted them or the person who had them sorted them, really confuses me how their sorting mechanism goes. But hey. So what kind of intrigued me, you know, I see the cards and penny sleeves, which so far we've determined isn't always a great thing. But I mean, there's this stuff, I didn't even look at it, but Eric Montross, Anthony Hardaway, that's cool, and Jamal Mashburn, and we got a Sterling Sharp game day. But there was just a bunch of different cards. I was like, well, maybe there's some 70s or cards in there, something like that. You never know. We have found them in there before. These look to be a little bit newer. That is kind of interesting. Flip them all around. Okay. Sorry about that. I had to take a cut there. But we were starting here. First off, we had Justin Upton right there in the front from Topps Heritage. A couple of those. Cards that were upside down. Corey Lukey. Wow. That guy was supposed to be a big deal. Casey Jansen. Charlton Jimerson. Tyler Johnson. Tim Cooney. The Hanley Ramirez rookie card. That's kind of cool. Nick Blackburn. Jay Bruce rookie card. This is like a blast from the past, guys. Jose Capellan. Wellington Castillo. Berto Callaspo, E.J. Cole, these are all rookie cards. Phil Koch, Jose Fernandez, rest in peace. Sean Gilmartin, Angel Guzman, Connor Gillespie, kind of looks like Matt Cain. Joey Gallo, look at that funny photo. Doing really well at the Dodgers though now, so honestly, hopefully he just tears the cover off the ball. And just, you know, gets back to being that player that he used to be. You know, at least hitting around 250. The 30, 40 homers. Gerard Dyson. Buck Farmer. Chase Headley. Wilken Castillo. Carlos Ruiz, that's pretty cool. A couple of those. Chris Bressop. Saul Rivera. Another Gillespie. Greg Golson. Keila Kaihui. Jeff Baisley, I don't remember him. Rodano Ventura passed away also. He was a pretty decent pitcher. Vincent Velasquez, Pat Venditti. There you go, that's cool. Switch pitcher. Could throw left-handed and right-handed. I don't know why teams took too long to call him up. I know he didn't throw that hard, but I mean, so what? Also, I was a big fan of his because he was homeschooled, like I was. So, yeah, There's a little tidbit if you didn't know that about me. There's Adam Lind. I think that's, Andy LaRoche. Francisco Liriano. Ian Kinzer, that's nice. Del One Young. Nate McClouth. Pretty decent player. Hard-nosed player. Adam Lowen. Lance McCullers Jr., he's a pretty decent player. Then we go to 84 tops randomly. Just got some guys from there. Then we go back. Kelvin Jimenez, Brandon Jones, Casey Jansen again, Jim Johnson, had a long career. Ryan Jorgensen, Jim Johnson. Chuck James, Kenji Jojima. He was a pretty good catcher. A couple of those. So that's kind of nice. Maybe we should continue looking at those. From 07, I think. 06, Joe Inglet. Paul Hoover. Sean Hill. I guess I don't have to say every name, right? Brendan Harris. There's a Raul Ibanez rookie card. Lucas Duda. Jason Hirsch. The Rockies picked him up and he just was always injured. Because I think that was the same Jason Hirsch, I'm not entirely sure. Kyle Drabek, he was supposed to be another big one too. Jordan Walton, he was good for a while. There's Bill Scherer randomly in there. There's a Gary Carter. Hey, we'll throw that inside to the side for Carter's kids. I told him I'd set aside some. And we got a little stack going for him. Man of the Year, Ryan Sandberg. I don't think I have that one. I mean, so far, I'd say, honestly, it was worth it. There's also this cool sports flex card I wanted to pull out. Jesse Barfield. So, yeah. Hey, we got some Desert Storm cards. So, Strike Eagle. There's the Apache. AV8B. I have an unopened pack of these that Henry gave me. There's the Tomcat Falcon. E3A AWACS. It's a Tornado. USS Long Beach. USS Charles F. Adams. USS S. Oliver Perry. There's the Blue Ridge. Wisconsin, firing a volley there. Arkansas, there's the M551 tanks, MLRS. Those are pretty still used. I don't know if it's the MLRS, but that the rocket firing still used today. T-72, it's a really blurry photo. BMP-1, that must have been what the other side was using, or allies, I'm not sure. M2, Patriot, cluster bombs, there's some MK-83s, and some guys loading them, and then the AT-4 rocket RPG. So that's kind of cool. We got some Desert Storm cards. What are these? Got a random Blue Jays Jesse Barfield card with the Bellingham Mariners 1989. Wow. I wonder if there's anybody in here. This is an interesting box. Roger Salkeld, I guess. I recognize that name. Like the whole team set. Doesn't look like it. I think Gary Willock played in the majors. Jerry Walker. I don't think he was a baseball player. And we got the Bat Boys. Wow. So that's kind of interesting. Let's go here. We got some cards in penny sleeves. So Jermaine Fazande, don't know why he's in there. James Johnson, we got Joe Cribbs, a whole bunch of them. We got Ted Hendricks, okay, that makes more sense. Randy Cross and Jim Plunkett. Looks like the penny sleeve was sliced. So some nice 83 Topps football. Some more of those Blue Jays cards. Jim Clancy, Saito Gaston, Tom Filer, Mark Eichhorn, Dennis Lamp, and Garth Jorg. And those are from 1986 Bubble Yum. Well, that's one of their sponsors, I guess. I don't know. we got a Boomer Esiason from 89, Warren Moon, Herschel Walker. I think he's running for, he won the Republican primary in the state of Georgia. And I think he's running to unseat either the Democrat that won or another Republican, I'm not sure. So he's a nice guy. I've heard him speak on the radio several times. Very nice guy. Knows what he's talking about. If I was in Georgia, I'd vote for him, but I can't. Yeah. So yeah, there's some nice 80s football. Some more early 80s baseball. I guess those are always cool to get for that price. Dave Lemanchik. There's a Christian Guzman. Donruss Originals randomly in there. Maybe there's a Calvin Jr. rookie card in there somewhere. Probably not, but you never know. Got Franco Harris, who is still apparently playing in 83. I didn't know that. Gerald Riggs. Too bad they're all dinged up in the corner, but we'll take a look, see if we need those cards yet. Here's some more of the Blue Jays. Maybe we have an entire set. That'd be kind of cool. I think there's another one right here. John Sullivan, Steve Davis, John McLaren, just the whole team. Hey, Cecil Fielder, rookie card right there. That's got to be worth at least a dollar, right? I mean, how common are these? George Bell, Cliff Johnson, Jeff Heron, Jim Acker, Ernie Witt, Rance Molinix, Bill Caudill, Jimmy Key, Tom Henke, Doyle Alexander, Willie Upshaw, Rick Leach, Jimmy Williams, Kelly Gruber, Tony Fernandez, Billy Smith, Lloyd Mosby, Don Gordon, Al Widmar, Damaso Garcia, Buck Martinez, and Carol DeVell. We're missing Dave Steed. Where's Dave Steed? We got some basketball in there, too. I think we've seen enough of basketball this week. We got the 93 Select. Those were kind of cool cards, if you want something different. And it looks like we have some more rookie cards, so we can at least finish with that. My arms are getting tired. So we almost got the complete set, looks like, in those Blue Jays. So we got Mitch Jones. All these cards are turned around. There's a number card in there. Hold up. Okay, we'll know it when we get there. Nick Massett, Dustin McGowan, Edward Mojica, played for a while, played in the Rockies too. Then we got Mike Napoli, rookie card, that's cool. Addison Reed, Hansel Robles, Jeff Samardzija, Eric Breitz, DJ Bone, Justin Nodler, Masumi Kawada, Josh Kinney, Jeff Karstens, Josh Kinney, put them together. Don Kelly, I think he went on to play the Tigers. Brad Kilby. There's a couple Trevor Mays. Lucas May. Brandon Harper. Wrong Harper on the Nationals. Got a Matt Kemp rookie card. That's cool. Hanley Ramirez rookie card again. Jason Hamill. Was pretty awful with the Rockies, but went on to be kind of somewhat alright. Jason Kubel. Got a really old Monty Irvin card, 1975. So Aaron Davis would be a fan of that right there. 1975 TCMA. Got Bobby Keelty. Got a Tony Gwynn from 85 Fleer. It's a Jared Weaver rookie. Yogi Berra from 81. I already have that one. Justin Upton. We got a Josh Johnson Chrome. That's numbered to 1962. Got a Paul Konerko. That's numbered 999. Got the White Sox Gold. Josh Beckett Gold. Another White Sox Gold. Got Nick Markakis, optic card there. Might be chrome, I don't know. Or refractor, I'm not sure. Meat of the Mets, gold. And finally, Asher Wojciechowski. So, I think so far, that might have been the best box we've had in a while. So, that was definitely a blast from the past. Hopefully, you guys had as fun as I did going through those. So really appreciate you sticking around and watching these with me. Let me know if you had any favorites there, anybody that surprised you. Let me know if you think it was worth it or not. I'd love to hear it. Talk to you guys later. Bye.